the continuation of work energy, laws of conservation of energy. See, the laws of conservation of energy states that the energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. And whenever energy changes from one form into another, the total amount of energy remains constant. See, when we throw a ball up, the chemical energy stored in our body gets transferred to the ball, and its kinetic energy also, right? As the ball moves up, it loses the kinetic energy and gains potential energy. At the highest point, all of its kinetic energy changes into potential energy as the ball falls on the ground. Its potential energy changes into heat and sound. Although energy is being transformed from one form to another at every stages, yet its total amount remains unchanged, and it is same, right? So this is the principle of conservation of energy. And what we said, that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It may be transferred from one form to another only. And the total energy of a system remains constant. And as the entire universe may be regarded as an isolated system, the total energy of the universe is constant. If one part of the universe loses energy, another part must gain an equal amount of energy, right? Now, what are conservative force and non-conservative force, we'll see. Okay, see, a force Fx is conservative if it can be derived from a scalar quantity by the relation del V, which is equal to minus Fx del X. The work done by the conservative force depends only on the endpoints. That also we said that W, which is equal to Kf minus Ki, which is equal to V of Xi minus V of Xf, which depends on the endpoints. And the work done by the force is a closed path, the zero. This is once again apparent from W, which is equal to Kf minus Ki, which is equal to V of Xi minus V of Xf, right? And non-conservative force, which means the work done by the non-conservative forces, that are all depend on the path in which it is done. The work done by this force in a closed path is non-zero here. And the friction is an example for non-conservative force. The heat energy produced by friction gets dissipated and hence cannot be converted back into the original form of energy. Now, see, from the law of conservation of energy, the conservation of mechanical energy by gravitational force we can see. See, through the example of the, in case of a freely falling body, we can see that suppose a ball of mass M, which is dropped from a height H, and V of H now, which is equal to zero, and V of H at the height H, which is equal to position B, and V naught at the ground level, that is position C. We'll see one by one positions, right? Now, the ball which we have taken, the mass M, which is placed at A. Now, we can say that the mechanical energy at A, how we have to derive it? The height H, that is, we have taken A be the height of the above the ground, right? Above the ground we have taken, and therefore the mechanical energy possessed by the ball is wholly by the virtue of its position, and hence only potential energy is present, right? So the potential energy at A, which is equal to, we can say, mgh. So the kinetic energy here at A, which is equal to zero. So what is the total mechanical energy in this point at A? So So E A R K E, which is equal to the potential energy plus kinetic energy, which is equal to MGH plus zero. So the mechanical energy at point A, which is equal to MGH. Okay. Now we will see the mechanical energy at point B. Now at point B, what will happen? See, you have to take V of H, right? So here, from the body which is moves from A to B. So PE, which is equal to here, MGH. We have to calculate the potential energy also here. We have to consider it. And the kinetic energy is half mv square, because it starts once falls, it starts, and the kinetic energy is increased. So that half mv square, so half m v of h square we have taken, because here we have taken v of small h at b, right? But v of small h square, which is equal to 2g into h minus h, we have to take it. The distance ab we have to calculate. So h minus h we have to take it. So the kinetic energy, which is equal to mg capital H minus mgh. So what is now the mechanical energy at B? Mgh plus mgh minus mgh. We will get the value for the potential energy here. Got it? And at C, we can see at the position C, now it's coming and reached the ground. So the ball at C has fallen through the height H and it's gained the velocity. Now this has the maximum velocity. It's gained velocity. So now the velocity is at maximum. So now what will be the potential energy is zero. The kinetic energy, which is equal to half mv naught square. So 2gh will come. So finally we want the mechanical energy at point C, so that PEC plus kinetic energy, that is potential energy plus kinetic energy, here you will get mgh, right? So from the three cases we may understand that the EA, which is equal to EB and which is equal to EC, is it right? So clearly we can got that the total mechanical energy of the body at A, B and C, right? The total mechanical energy of the body throughout the free fall is what? Conserved, right? And the graphical representation for that above explanation part, you may see that the conservation of the total mechanical energy of a body under the vertical motion. See, the potential energy of V, the graph is versus energy and height. We have taken E, which is equal to, that is the total energy, which is equal to kinetic energy plus the potential energy both. When an object is dropped from a height, that is what will happen? The PE will get decreased from its maximum value to zero, and its kinetic energy is increased because the energy is getting transferred, right? So it is increased from zero to maximum value simultaneously, right? So that is one type of mechanical energy is converted into another type of mechanical energy, right? At the height, now we have C H by 2, half H. The mechanical energy is half potential and half kinetic. This is also one type of, that we can say, the changing energy. And we can understand that E, which is equal to K plus V, that is remains its constant at any point. Understand? So when an object is projected vertically upward, the kinetic energy decreases from its maximum value to zero, and its potential energy increases from zero to its maximum value simultaneously. You can see that through this example. Got it? So you must know to draw the both different types of graphs, and both will indicate that the one type of mechanical energy is converted to another type of mechanical energy, right? Yes. Now, conservation of mechanical energy by spring force. We'll see. As same we have seen the potential energy of a spring, right? Here the conservation of energy of an elastic spring. If we stretched a spring to a distance of xm, its potential energy is what? With the help of the previous class, you may seen that kx square by 2 or kxm suffix m square by 2. When it is released, what will happen? It begins to move under the spring. It reaches equilibrium positions x, which is equal to 0, where it has a maximum velocity, right? And now all the potential energy is what will happen? It's converted into kinetic energy due to the inertial of motion, right? So the body overshoots x, which is equal to 0 position, and its velocity decreases until its position is getting changed. x minus x, that is only we seen, right? And where all the kinetic energy converted into the potential energy. Now the spring force again pulls the body towards the position x, which is equal to 0. So now the body keeps on oscillating, right? So it keeps on oscillating. The total mechanical energy now, it gets remain constant. Now we can see one by one position. At the extreme position, what will happen? At the extreme position, x, which is equal to what? Plus or minus xm. We have to take from the above explanation, work done, which is equal to minus of integral xi to xf kx dx, as we have already explained through kinetic energy and the potential energy explanation part. Thus, the work done by the spring force depends only on the endpoints, right? We got it. And the block is pulled from xi and allowed to return to xi position. So what will happen that time? It's 0. Now the work done in round trip is 0. The spring force, we are telling that is conservative force. Is it right? So we'll see the extreme position and intermediate position, and for the equilibrium position. Okay. See, at the equilibrium position, x, which is equal to 0, which means u, which is equal to what? Half k into x square. The x is 0, then that is 0. Here k value we have to get, that is the kinetic energy value, which is equal to half mv square, that is equal to half into k x square, it will come, right? Then the position, if suppose in extreme, that time u value will be maximum, is it right? X value is 0. If suppose it is intermediate, means what will happen? The total energy, which is what? Kinetic energy and the potential energy. So that half mv square is kinetic energy. The potential energy, we got it from the graphical representation and the spring constant. What is the formula? Yes, half kx square. So both we have taken means v, which is equal to root of k by m, x m square or x square minus x. So we will get the maximum speed, that v suffix m, which is equal to root of k m into x, right? So the variation of the kinetic energy, the potential energy and the total energy with the displacement x, which you may see through that the graphical representation, that will show that as both kinetic energy and the potential energy depend on x square. Their graph are what? Parabolic. So the total mechanical energy E, which is equal to x plus u, remains constant. So its graph is what? It is a straight line. Yes, straight line parallel to displacement axis. So this is the conservation of energy in an elastic spring. Got it, children? Thank you, students.